Hey guys, it's Dotsler. This will be a quick video for the Sony has revealed the PlayStation Vita memory card accessories and other peripherals for the PlayStation Vita prices and info. So I'll just go over that and discuss what is in the early edition of the PlayStation Vita bundle. That'll come later. It's a bit of a surprise. It's pretty awesome. So, here we go. The 4 GB memory card, $19.99. 8 GB memory card, $29.99. 16 GB memory card, $59.99. 32 GB memory card, $99.99. So, as you might have heard before, the memory cards were said to be pretty expensive. And they still are, but they aren't expensive as thought before. For example, the 32 GB memory card was said to be $130. Now it's $99.99. And the 4 GB memory card was said to be $29.99. Now it's $19.99. If I were buying a memory card, and I'm not going to be, and I'll tell you why later, I would be getting the 8 GB because it's only $10 more than the 4 GB, and you get twice as much space, and it's half as much as a 16 GB memory card in size and price. But 8 GB is a lot of space, and considering you can save data and DLC on the game card, you won't really need it unless you're downloading like movies or other games from the PlayStation Store. So, that's the one I would be getting, but I'm not going to, and I'll tell you why later again. We'll get down to the peripherals, and then we'll get down to the chargers. So, here is the peripherals. The in-ear headset, $19.99. That is like their, the ones that come with the iPhones? I know that's not Sony, I'm just using it as an example. It's the regular earbuds, and then there's a mic attached. That's what they're doing here. So, I think you could use that in game for like chats and stuff. And it has a mic supposedly, so might be able to use it instead of like a Bluetooth headset. You could also use on the Vita because it has Bluetooth. And also has a built-in mic. So. And the carrying case and the travel pouch are each $19.99. I do not know what the difference is, so I'm not going to try and explain it. So, protective film, you get two for $9.99. And that is protecting the screen, and you could probably use it for the back touchpad, but there isn't really any reason to. $9.99, that's pretty expensive considering you can get it on Amazon, per se, for probably $2. That's funny. $2. So the card case. It holds four cards, either two game cards and two memory cards, or four memory cards, because the memory cards are smaller than the game cards. By a lot, actually. It's about half the size. That is $5.99. That's a pretty good price. The cradle, it charges and it has speakers. That is $19.99. That's also a pretty good price. Portable charger. Now, if you hadn't heard before, the PS Vita, with all of its functions on high or just on like the 3G and Wi-Fi and Bluetooth and GPS. If those are all on and the screen is on full and you're playing a graphically demanding game like Uncharted, it only gets 3 hours of battery life with all those functions on or using them. So the portable charger, $49.99. Okay? That is pretty expensive. I don't know how much life that has, but it's kind of necessary if you think about it. Unless you're going to be playing it at home or you could just plug it in and lay on the couch or whatever. But if you're going to be traveling at all, you're definitely going to need a portable charger. 3 hours, that's not even a plane ride from, like, I don't know, California to Georgia, say. So, yeah, you're definitely going to need that. I won't be getting it right away, but I'm definitely going to be needing it. I'll definitely get it eventually, but not right away. The AC adapter, this is the one you plug into a wall. I'm assuming comes with the system when you buy it, but I do not know for sure. So that is $14.99. The car adapter is you plug it into the cigarette lighter and charges your system. $14.99 also, and the USB cable is to transfer data and probably charge it as well. $14.99. Now, the system, the Wi-Fi only version with the rest of the functions also that the 3G version has, except for I think GPS, okay, that is $250. The 3G Wi-Fi, and I think only the 3G version is GPS. That one is $300. And now, that's pretty expensive for a system, but not for the PS Vita. Okay? Because think about it. How much stuff does the PS Vita have in it? Let's just use the 3G Wi-Fi version as an example. $300. Okay? Wi-Fi, 3G, GPS, Bluetooth, gyroscope, dual touchscreen / pad, dual cameras, a microphone, dual analogs, a quad-core processor, and, yeah, that is a lot of technology, so, that is extremely cheap if you think about how much that technology would be on its own. So the way they're expecting to make their money, because they're expecting losses from selling the PlayStation Vita alone, just the PS Vita, they're expecting to make money from the peripherals and the memory cards, all the accessories, and the games. So you're getting a pretty good deal if you think about it. It sounds expensive, but it's really a good deal. Except maybe the memory cards. Those are still sounds pretty expensive, but you know they have to make money. And I also forgot something. There's a starter kit with a memory card for $39.99. I don't know what it contains, but I'm assuming it's not going to be a high-end memory card like a 16 or 32, because those themselves are more than the starter kit. So it's probably a 4-8 gig with a case and maybe some protective film or something, but I don't know. So like I said before in the beginning of the video, there's a bit of a surprise. If you're not aware, there was about a month span where you could get an early edition PS Vita bundle. And you get it a week early. So all these accessories, their dates, it says they're available February 15th, except for the car adapter and the portable charger that says spring 2012. But, back to the point, they say February 15th, and yet the PS Vita technically doesn't come out until February 22nd. So why could you get it a week early? There was an early edition bundle. You get it a week early, and it's $350. And here's what it contains. The 3G Wi-Fi version of the PS Vita, that alone is $300. So you get a 4 GB memory card. That alone is $20. And you get a traveling pouch or carrying case. I do not know what the difference is, again. So those are each $19.99 alone. Anyways. So if you add all that up, $340. But you also get a game. So, it is Little Deviants. That's definitely not the game I would want, but it's a free game. And if I was going to buy this stuff already, it's basically the same price, except you get a free game. So, it is $3.50, the whole bundle. The deal's over at Amazon where I placed mine. So, I do not know where else you could have gotten it. Probably the Sony store, but it's probably over there too. I think it was just a limited edition. Sucks for you if you didn't know it was out, but that means I will be doing a, not early, because it's already out in Japan, so that sounds kind of stupid, but an early slash late unboxing of the rest of the world's, excluding Japan's, PS Vita, because I'm hoping that they're solving some of the problems with the Japanese versions. Because if you haven't heard, they also have like software issues, and you can't initiate your PlayStation Network account. The cutouts from the wireless connectivity, and you can't receive data. But anyways, so yeah, comes out February 15th, like I said before, but you can't get it the day it comes out. From, and these weren't in stores, by the way, so supposedly I'll be getting mine February 17th, so as soon as I get it, I promise I will unbox it. I am just dying to get my hands on one, like, just play the shit out of Uncharted Golden Abyss. I cannot wait. So yeah, I pre-ordered Little Big Planet and Uncharted Golden Abyss also, so those do not come February 15th or whenever I'll get my early edition bundle, but they will be there on February 22nd. So I'll do separate unboxings and quick setup and gameplay of each of those games. And I also ordered Resistance Burning Skies, but supposedly that doesn't come out until way later in the year. So yeah, I'm extremely excited for all this stuff. It's shaping up to be a really good looking addition to the PlayStation family, which is already awesome as fuck. So yeah, and if you haven't heard, I will be trying to go to a so-called PlayStation or PS Vita convention, and there is one of five places in the United States that they have display of the PS Vita open to the public, and I'll be going to one hopefully Monday, so I'll try and capture some gameplay and system info, put it up on YouTube. So yeah, this basically wraps up the video, and if you enjoyed, make sure you come back to Dossler PSN for more info on PS Vita primarily, and just PlayStation information and gaming in the future. I'm sorry to say that I do not have my PS3 right now, so I'll be posting primarily PSP, PS2, and sad to say it, PS1 games, but if I can, I will try and download Fraps, but my computer sucks ass, so I won't be able to record like some Need for Speed or Grand Theft Auto or Minecraft that I have on my computer, but yeah, so I'll just try and do as many information videos as I can, because I do not have my PS3 right now. I'm extremely sad. Really. Not even exaggerating. I'm, like, on the verge of tears. It's fucking sad. No, I'm just kidding. But it's pretty boring. So yeah. Just come back for more info, and try and put up some SOCOM PSP gameplay later. If my fucking PSP starts working. It's not necessarily not working, it's just I can't seem to get online and play some SOCOM because my account's all messed up, so. Yeah, hope you enjoyed, and, see you all later. Bye.